Good morning students, I am Moshmi Prasad and creator of this channel Digital Generation. This channel is regarding chapter wise preparation for both ICSE and CBSE students. I hope you will get best knowledge and explanation from this channel. Today we will study about the sign convention for spherical mirror and mirror formula. In the ray diagram for spherical mirrors, both concave and convex mirror, new Cartesian sign convention is used for measuring various distances. According to this new Cartesian sign convention, all the distances are measured from the pole as origin. The distances that are on the same direction as that of the incident light are taken as positive. Suppose this is the spherical mirror and this is the principal axis. This is the pole. All the distances are measured from the pole as origin. And number two, I said all the distances that are in the same direction as that of the incident light are taken as positive. All the distances that are on the right hand side of the pole will become positive, and all the distances that are on the left hand side will be considered as negative because incident light travels from left to right. Number three, the distances that are apart or perpendicular to the principal axis are considered as positive. This is the principal axis and the distance upward will be considered as positive. Again, the distance which are downward and are perpendicular to the principal axis will be considered as negative. We always place an object on the left hand side so that the incident light can travel from left side to right side. Thus, in new Cartesian sign convention, object distance are always considered as negative because it is on the left hand side of the mirror or against the direction of the light of incident. The light of incident ray will travel from this side to this side. This is the object, so incident ray will travel from left side to right side. Now about the images, when the image will be formed on the right hand side or in the direction of the incident light, then they will be considered as positive. Thus, if the images are formed on the right hand side or behind the mirror, then the image distances will be considered as positive. But if the image is formed on the left hand side or in front of the mirror, then the image distance will be considered as negative. But if the images are formed on the right hand side or in the same direction as that of the incident light ray, then they will be considered as positive. We know that in convex mirror, all the images are formed behind the mirror. This is the convex mirror. All the images will be formed behind the mirror, that is on the right hand side. So all the image distances will be considered as positive. But in case of concave mirror, the images are formed either on the right hand side or on the left hand side of the mirror. If the images are formed here on the right hand side or behind the mirror, then they will be considered as positive. The images that are formed behind the mirror are always virtual and erect, and so they are considered as positive. Whereas in concave mirror, where the images will be formed on the left hand side or against the direction of the ray of incident light, then they will be considered as negative because they are real and inverted images. Now we will discuss about the focal length of the mirror. In convex mirror, the focal length is on the right hand side, so it will be considered as positive. Thus, in convex mirror, focal length is positive because it is on the right hand side or in the same direction as that of the incident light. But in case of concave mirror, the focus is on the left hand side. The focus is here on the left hand side, so focal distance will be considered as negative in case of concave mirror. So in case of concave mirror, we will write F is equal to minus 10 or minus 20. This negative sign means that the mirror is concave mirror and so the focal length is negative. But whereas in case of convex mirror, we will write F is equal to plus 10 or plus 20. This means that the focal length is positive, that is the mirror is convex mirror. By saying the sign of this focal length, we can understand whether the mirror is concave mirror or convex mirror. If the focal length is negative, then the mirror is concave mirror, and if the focal length is positive, then the mirror is convex mirror. Now we will discuss new Cartesian sign convention regarding the height of the objects and the images. The objects are always placed above the principal axis, so the height of the object are always considered as positive. In any mirror, either it is concave mirror or convex mirror, the height of the object is always positive because it is placed above the principal axis. But if the image is formed behind the mirror and it is formed above the principal axis, then the height of the image will also be considered as positive because the image is virtual and erect. As the image is virtual and erect, so the height of the image will also be considered as positive. But in case of real and inverted image, when the image is formed in front of the mirror or on the left hand side, then the height of the image will be considered as negative because it is formed below the principal axis. Now we will discuss about the mirror formula. The distance of the object from the pole, suppose this is the object, either it is concave mirror or convex mirror. The distance of the object from the pole, this is the pole in convex mirror and this is the pole in concave mirror. So the distance of the object from the pole is considered as object distance. It is represented by U. Now, as the object is placed on the left hand side or in the direction which is against the direction of the incident light ray, so the distance of the object will be considered as negative. Thus, U is always negative in both the mirror. Object distance is negative in both the mirror. The distance of the image from the pole is considered as image distance. This is U, the distance of the object from the pole, and the distance of the image from the pole is known as image distance and is represented by the letter V. It may be either on the left hand side or right hand side. Wherever it is, it depends upon the position of the object. So the sign of the image distance also varies. If it is formed on the right hand side or behind the mirror, then the image distance will be considered as positive. But if the image is formed on the left hand side, then the image distance will be considered as negative. So the distance of the image from the pole is known as image distance. Now focal length. The distance of the focus from the pole is known as focal length. And in case of concave mirror, the focal length is on the left hand side, so the focal length is negative. Concave mirror have negative focal length, and in convex mirror the focal length is positive because in convex mirror the focal length is on the right hand side. Here will be the focus. So the distance of the focus from the pole is known as the focal length. And as it is on the right hand side, so it will be considered as positive. Thus, in convex mirror, focal length is positive. Now, it has been found that there is a relationship between the object distance, image distance, and the focal length, and which is represented by a formula known as mirror formula. So, what is mirror formula? The formula which represents the relationship between the object distance, image distance, and focal length is known as mirror formula. And according to this formula, 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. V means image distance, U means object distance, and F means focal length. Thus, if we know the two values, then we can find the third value. But one thing is to be kept in mind, that we have to put the values with proper sign, and the sign must be taken from the new Cartesian sign convention. Then only we can find out the third value from this formula. Now we will study about another thing which is known as linear magnification. We have seen in the ray diagram of the spherical mirror, the image may be either bigger or smaller or of the same size of the object. So it depends upon the position of the object where it is placed in front of the mirror. As the size of the image varies according to the position of the object, so the size of the image relative to the size of the object is given by linear magnification, and it is represented by the word M. Thus, m is equal to ratio of the height of the image to the height of the object. The height of the object is given by h1. H1 means height of the object. And height of the image is written as h2. Thus, magnification is equal to h2 by h1. This is the magnification. Height of the object is always positive because it is placed above the principal axis. So h1 is always positive. Now, height of the image. Height of the image is considered as positive when it is above the principal axis and it is virtual and erect image. Then we will get height of the object as positive. In case of convex mirror, the height is always positive because in convex mirror we get virtual, erect and diminished image. But in case of concave mirror, the height of the image may be either positive or negative. In concave mirror, when the image is formed behind the mirror, then the height of the image will be considered as positive. When the object is placed within the focal length, then we get virtual and erect image behind the mirror, which is positive. But in other cases of concave mirror, when the object is placed anywhere between pole and infinity, then we get real and inverted image. And so the height of the image will be considered as negative in that cases. So the sign of the magnification depends upon the sign of the height of the image. If the height of the image is positive, then magnification will also become positive, because h1 is always positive. But when the height of the image is negative, then the sign of the magnification will be negative. Thus, if we have negative sign in magnification, then we can understand that the image is real and inverted, because magnification is having negative sign. But if the magnification is having positive sign, then we can understand that the image is virtual and erect, because it is having positive sign. So the image must be virtual image and formed behind the mirror. But if the magnification has negative value, then we can understand that the image is real and inverted and is formed in front of the mirror. This is about the sign of the magnification. Now we will discuss about the value of the magnification. If the value of the magnification is less than 1, then the image is smaller than the object. If the value of the magnification is equal to 1, then the size of the image is equal to the size of the object. When the magnification is greater than 1, then the image will be enlarged or bigger than that of the object. So we can write that if magnification is less than 1, then it will be smaller than the object or diminished image. In case of convex mirror, we know virtual, erect and diminished image is formed. So in that case, the value of magnification will always be less than 1. But if the magnification is equal to 1, then it will be same size of the object. In case of plane mirror, the size of the image is equal to the size of the object. Or in case of concave mirror, when the object is placed at center of curvature, then real inverted image is formed, which will be equal to the size of the object. And it is also formed at C. So in concave mirror also we get equal to 1 when the object is placed at C or center of curvature. When the magnification is greater than 1, then the image is magnified or enlarged. This happens in case of concave mirror when the object is placed within the focal length, then virtual, erect and enlarged image is formed behind the mirror. By going through some examples, it will be more clear. An object is placed in case 1 at 20 cm, in case 2 at 4 cm in front of a concave mirror which is having a focal length of 12 cm. Find the nature of image formed in each case. Now we will put the value. In first case, case 1, object u is equal to 20 cm. Object distance are always negative because it is placed on the left hand side of the mirror. And f is here also negative because it is a concave mirror. Now from mirror formula we will find the image distance. 1 by v plus 1 by u is equal to 1 by f. 1 by v minus object distance is 1 by 20 is equal to minus 1 by 12. We have to put the sign properly. The focal length of concave mirror is negative. 1 by V is equal to 1 by 12 plus 1 by 20. We will find out the LCM. 60 minus 5, 3. 2 by 60 minus 2 by 60. That is 1 by 30. That is 1 by V is equal to minus 1 by 30, or V is equal to minus 30 centimeter. Thus, an image is formed at 30 centimeter in front of the mirror or on the left hand side, and the image is real and inverted because it is having negative sign. So in first case, we are getting real inverted image at 30 centimeter in front of the mirror or on the left hand side of the mirror. Now we will consider the second case. In second case, object distance is equal to minus 4 centimeter, because object distances are always negative and focal length will be same, minus 12 centimeter. Put the value in mirror formula. 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F, or 1 by V minus 1 by 4 is equal to 1 by 12. Focal length will be negative. 1 by V is equal to minus 1 by 12 plus 1 by 4 is equal to, we will find the LCM. LCM is 12 minus 1 plus 3 is equal to plus 2 by 12. 1 by V is equal to 1 by 6, or V is equal to 6 centimeter. That is, virtual and erect images formed when the object is placed at 4 centimeter. Here the positive sign indicates that it is virtual and erect image. Thus, in second case, virtual erect image is formed at 6 centimeter behind the mirror or on the right hand side of the mirror. Behind the mirror. This is about the mirror formula. Now we will take another example to find the height of the object or image. Now look at this example. If an object of 10 cm height is placed at a distance of 36 cm from a concave mirror of focal length 12 cm, find the position, nature and height of the image. So we will write the information first. Here height of the object is given 10 cm. Height of the object is always positive because it is placed above the principal axis. And object distance is 36 centimeter. Object distance are always negative because they are placed on the left hand side of the mirror. And focal length is given 12 centimeter. It is a concave mirror. So focal length will be negative, minus 12 centimeter. Now we will use the mirror formula to find the image distance. 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. 1 by V minus 1 by 36. Image distance is 36 is equal to minus 1 by 12. Or 1 by V is equal to minus 1 by 12 plus 1 by 36. We will find the LCM of 12 and 36. It is 36. 3 minus 3 plus 1 is equal to minus 2 by 36 is equal to 1 by 18. Thus, 1 by V is equal to minus 1 by 18, or V is equal to minus 18 centimeter. So the image is formed at 18 centimeter in front of the mirror or on the left hand side of the mirror because there is a negative sign. This negative sign of the image distance indicates that the image is real and inverted and is formed in front of the mirror or on the left hand side of the mirror. Which type of mirror? Concave mirror. So what is the nature of the image? It is real, inverted and formed at 18 centimeter in front of the mirror. This is the nature and position of the image. Now we have to find the height of the image. Here height of the object is given 10 centimeter. So we know from the formula of magnification that H2 by H1 is equal to minus V by U. Here h2 we have to find it out. H1 is given 10 centimeter and height of the object is always positive. Minus v, v is equal to minus 18 centimeter. The value of v is minus 18 centimeter because it is real and inverted image and formed in front of the mirror. So we will put the minus sign here. And the object distance is minus 36. Object distances are always negative. Is equal to minus half. H2 by 10 is equal to minus half. Or H2 is equal to minus 22 is equal. H2 is equal to minus 5 centimeter. This negative sign of the height of the image indicates that it is real and inverted image and is formed below the principal axis. So there is a negative sign. Thus the height of the image is 5 centimeter, whereas the height of the object is 10 centimeter. Thus the image is smaller than the object, just half of the object. Therefore height is 5 centimeter below the principal axis and is smaller than the object. This minus sign indicates that it is real and inverted image and is formed below the principal axis. Now we will take an example from convex mirror to show how to use mirror formula. An object 1 cm tall is placed 30 cm in front of a convex mirror of focal length 20 cm. Find the size and position of the image formed in the convex mirror. So here height of the object is 1 centimeter, and u, object distance, is equal to minus 30 centimeter. Object distance is always negative, either it is concave mirror or convex mirror. Another thing is given, focal length f is 20 centimeter. It is a convex mirror, so focal length will be positive. From this we will find the image distance by using mirror formula. 1 by v plus 1 by u is equal to 1 by f. 1 by v minus 1 by 30 is equal to 1 by 20. Or 1 by v is equal to 1 by 20 plus 1 by 30. We will take the LCM. 3, 2 is equal to 5 by 60. 1 by v is equal to 1 by 12 or v is equal to 12 centimeter. The positive sign indicates that the image is virtual and erect. So virtual and erect image is formed at 12 centimeter behind the mirror or on the right hand side of the mirror. So virtual erect image is formed at 12 centimeter behind the convex mirror or on the right hand side of the mirror, because it is positive sign, because image distance is having positive sign. Now we will find to find the height of the object. Before that we have to find the magnification. M is equal to minus V by U is equal to, V is equal to 12 and U is equal to minus 30 is equal to minus 6 to the 12, 6, 5, 13 plus minus number, minus 2 by 5 is equal to plus 2 by 5. Thus M is equal to 2 by 5. The positive sign of M indicates that the image is virtual and erect. So we got the value of M as 2 by 5. Now we will find the height of the image. M is equal to h2 by h1. M is equal to 2 by 5. H2 we have to find it out, and h1 is 1 centimeter. So h2 is equal to 2 by 5 is equal to 0.4 centimeter. Thus height of the image is 0.4 centimeter. The positive sign indicates that it is virtual and erect image. So the height of 0.4 centimeter of image is formed at 12 cm behind the mirror and the value of magnification here is less than 1. As the value of magnification is less than 1, 0.4, so it means that the image form is smaller or diminished than that of the object. So virtual, erect and diminished image is formed at 12 cm behind the mirror. Now to see more examples from this chapter, mirror formula or new Cartesian sign convention, look at the PDF and click the link given below. Thank you for watching my video, and if you find my video useful, please do like and share my video and subscribe my channel to get the latest update of my videos. And if you have any doubt regarding this topic, comment below. I will try to answer as early as possible.